Over here.
Yes, Mom?
Got it.
Have you seen your father?
Dad went to get water.
Hey, wait for me!
Let's not give it back to him.
Come on. Pulse it.
I scared you, right? Now tell the truth.
The hairs on my neck are all standing on end.
What was I supposed to do? I know. Yes. Yeah. All right. Giselle!
Men.
Did you see that?
Yes, but what was that?
Only hard as a rock, sun-dried hyena poo-poo.
Oh, I see.
Finny!
Well, how do I look?
Totally chic. Unbelievable.
Darling, this is a work of art. I call it macaroni and cheese. It would suit you too, Giselle. And while you're at it, a good neck wax wouldn't hurt.
No, thanks.
It's a matter of concentration.
Yes, clearly.
And the perfect wind conditions?
Naturally.
Turtle dove.
What are you doing?
Hello, Bonnie. You look lovely.
What are we doing? Walking around, thinking, and we're talking, and,
hitting hyena poo into a hole?
That as well. I was just going to tell you.
You hit hyena poo-poo into a hole.
With a stick?
Oh, with a stick.
Bingo.
Interesting. And who thought that little one up?
Me! I thought that little one up!
I thought so.
Oh.
What were you supposed to do today?
Supposed to do today? Socrates, do you know?
You were to get water.
Oh, that's right!
Oh, Billy. I really think you are and always will be a scatterbrain. But I sure love you.
This is serious.
Don't tell me. You went to a beauty salon.
Hmm?
It'll grow out. It's a law of nature.
I didn't say a thing.
Oh, stop acting like such a fool. It's the water that flows down the mountainside. It should have got here by now.
Yeah. I'll play the water down here with my drum.
Yeah.
politicians and economic leaders have gathered for the 167th Climate Conference. Here to the north, they've all come as these brave officials examine the dramatic effects of global warming.
Quick, the buffet's getting cold.
Peter Cook reporting from Thule, Greenland, the gateway to the Arctic.
This was a wonderful day, Winifred.
I've heard you say that for exactly 714 years. Know what?
Of course I know. It's our wedding anniversary, and I wouldn't have wanted to miss a single day.
Ground? Bah! Something's moving all righty. Yes!
My dear, the time has come for us to be getting on our way once more.
Getting's good is good.
Here's to you, jumpy buddy.
Oh!
Tell you what, I'm going to call you Smiley. Crikey, strong stuff, mate. Cheers. You know, Smiley, life's just too stressful here. How does an ocean cruise sound? Think of it, the high life on the high seas. You know, relax, just really stretch out.
Good. Now smile. Soon you'll be braising in a choice burgundy.
You pathetic worm. Death to the tyrants!
Now just look at what I've done. I've forgotten the garlic. Don't run away. I'll be back soon.
Ooh la la.
It's liberty or death! Vive la France! Adieu!
A chicken? Huh? Hello and welcome. My name is Winifred.
And I, Winston.
The name's Toby.
Charles, it is a pleasure to make your acquaintance. With whom do I have the honor?
This is my friend Smiley. Things got a little bit steamy back in the bush, so we thought we'd take ourselves on a holiday, you know, to cool off. First it was just me and Smiley, but then old Sushi climbed aboard.
Sushi?
That's my name.
Yes. Well then, carry on, my fearless marsupial.
And then, 4 weeks out to sea, we met the tortoises. And since then, we've had a plan.
Ah, plan is good. What plan?
The migratory birds who used to visit us on our island in the summer told us of a paradise of wonder.
Far away from mankind.
Ah, oui, a charming idea. What a stroke of luck that you have met me. I will lead you!
La mer les a bercés le long des golfes clairs et d'une chanson d'amour la mer a bercé mon cœur pour la vie.
Oh. Our supplies are just about gone. The water holes are running dry.
Now that you mention it, my throat does feel rather dry. Oh, without water we're lost. And without water we'll die. Mm. My stress levels are through the roof. Mm. I'm having an anxiety attack. I'll shut up.
Well, I'll just consult with the oracle. Hmm?
An oracle consult? This could be good.
Mighty Oracle, we humbly seek your advice in this time of great fear and uncertainty. Tell us, when will the water come?
I would advise you now more than ever to keep the Oracle in good humor.
Lovely. That tree trunk just ate our last bunch of bananas.
Yes, the water will come when it comes, I suppose.
The water's coming?
The cup falls down the well until it breaks.
What in the world is that supposed to mean?
Please, Billy, you're insulting the Oracle.
If the water doesn't come, we have to find it then. Not stand here talking to a dried-up tree.
Huh? Did you just call me a dried-up tree? That guy's got some nerve, loser.
You offended the Oracle. It won't speak to us anymore.
That was slick, loser.
Hey, my dad's no loser.
Comrades, each one of us has tragically lost their home, their friends, their family, stolen from under our noses. And now, comrades, we will find ourselves a new place to live, one where there is no place for man.
Blah!
Spoken with conviction.
Right now, hit the punch! Now that's what I call some stress hormone.
We have all crossed the seven seas in nothing more than a rusty bathtub. We have weathered the most terrible of storms and evil of winds. We are so close to our goal.
You put your right foot in, you put your right foot out. You put your right foot in and you shake it all about. You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about.
Left foot!
You put your left foot in.
Oh, beyond those rocks, my friends, lies paradise. We are now ever so close to reaching our goal.
Hokey pokey and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about.
My dad is the best dad in the whole wide world. He's going to bring us water from the waterhole. He'll fight the rhinos and keep the buffalo away and chase away the elephants.
Whoa, dream on. Your dad's a zero. Get real.
Hmm?
And not to mention...
Mention what?
Well, the meerkats have a light coat set for him.
I guess my dad's just one of a kind.
Note to self. Get water. Piece of cake. First, shoo the buffalo away. Then fight off the rhinos. And then stop the elephants from drinking us dry.
Hey, Billy.
Psst.
Maybe if you let them drink first and then leave the water hole in a good mood, it's better and safer.
Giselle, please. Don't panic. Just take a good look at that idiot squad. Zero intelligence. If those bubble brains were any more clueless, their heads would explode.
Really?
Gino wants a drink. And Gino's gonna have a drink. Boys, let's have a drink.
Hey, I didn't hear anyone say you could have the first drink.
You talking to me? Are you talking to me, unicorn?
To that guy, just call me a unicorn. One sip, and I'll be watching all the buzzards pick your bones in the blinding sun.
Gino drinks when he wants to, see?
Oh, yeah. Then just try it, and you'll see.
Yeah, in your dreams, pizza face.
Tons of raw meat compared to a little natural charm.
Of a meek, weak, cheeky
little freak.
Stay calm and smile. Big toothy grin. Distract them. Hey, look over there! And discreetly fill the pumpkin. Da-da-da. And a little more for Daddy. You've got a problem, huh? Carrot Top?
Carrot Top.
Excuse me, who's talking to you, lightweight?
What?
I sure showed all of them. That big. They were all that big. With hats. Stop right here. Not another step.
Oh, Billy.
Hey, everything's under control, my turtledove. Ooh, and I've got the water. Well.
Oh, Billy.
Let's recap. Dad was supposed to chase away the buffalo and get water. Super!
I told them all you were going to get the water for us.
Oh. Junior, wait a minute.
Our supplies are just about gone.
It's okay, I'll work it all out.
Billy, you're such a dreamer. What will happen to us?
I promise. This time I'm not going to let you down.
Hey, Junior. There's your old man, the Rhino Whisperer.
Hello, my son.
Yes, what is it?
Well, I just wanted to let you know that I did promise your mother...
I've heard it before. You're always making promises you can't keep. Go and hang out with your lion, or go off and play your drum, or go off and hit some hyena poo-poo into a hole. You're not my father anymore. Billy. You shouldn't have said that. Leave me alone.
Socrates, we're needed. The very fate of Okavango is right in our hands.
And what kind of plant have you been chewing? Think and compare us to eternity. We're grains of sand, and that's all.
I'm not a grain of sand, buddy. I'm a meerkat. My family needs water. My son thinks I'm a big loser. That's what's real. And now my reality is to go and find water. And you're coming with me.
That is the stuff of a wonderful tragic ballad. The sweet yet sorrowful song of Billy the Meerkat who set out in search of water.
I can hear it! I can just hear it! Yeah, that's my song!
Alas, never to be seen again.
Eh?
And his old friend Socrates the Lion spent the rest of his days staying at home and growing old, gazing peacefully into the sky.
Then I'll just go it alone.
What? I'd think that one over again, because if you follow the riverbed, you come to the Valley of Death.
Hmm? Did you say Valley of Death? So how do you know?
That's easy, because I've been there.
You were in the Valley of Death?
Yes, it was long, long ago. You see my scar up here? Well, deep within the Valley of Death, there lives a murderous shadow.
The leopard?
Such a beast! Who can slice you to pieces before you see him coming? He who enters the Valley of Death gives up life itself.
You're not coming with me?
No, Billy. Let's just do what we know how to do. What we're best at doing. Laying around and killing time. Billy? Billy? Billy!
Silver for sailoring, rooms to let 50 cents. No phone, no pool, no pet.
I don't need no cigarettes. Ah, but 2 hours of pushing broom. That's a 8x12 four-bit broom. I'm a man of means by no means. King of the road.
Hey, what? Who do we have here?
Don't be shy. Come a little closer. Why not sit here with us for a while? We won't buy.
I fancy a change of pace, don't you?
A smidge on the bony side.
You don't have to be so negative. Welcome, lad, to the Valley of Joy.
I thought I was in the Valley of Death, right?
Valley of Death? Who put those thoughts in your head, son? Is this the Valley of Death, old chums?
Of course not. That's absurd.
Safe travels, my friend.
Catch you later.
Huh? Hello? Anybody there? Hello?
Hello? Hello?
Hello? Now we're gonna be fine. The leopard? Nala! Shoo, kitty! Go on back through your cat flap. I'll come out and show you whiskers, you scaredy cat.
Billy, violence will get you nowhere.
Huh? Well, so, what's plan B?
How does running sound to you?
Left, right, right, left.
Cosmic. And a kangaroo, tortoises, a two-legged mouth monster,
and a chicken.
Huh? A chicken? Pardon. A garlic cockerel is no mere chicken. Who are you? Who sent you? Where are you from? Tell me!
One card short of a full deck. But I tell you, the guy's got guts. Exactly like... It wasn't me.
Oh.
Socrates? What's the story behind your scar?
I was very young, inexperienced, rash, and very hungry. My brother and I...
Wait, you had a brother?
His name was Mambo. We were inseparable, racing across the savannah, chasing buffalo and hunting antelope.
Hold on, but you're a vegetarian.
Youth, you see, I was a cub. That was ages ago. So Mambo and I, though forbidden by our parents, walked right up to the Valley of Death. And as you can imagine, there was a good reason we were forbidden. After all, this is where the elephants came to die. But we knew no fear, and we were driven by curiosity.
Was it the leopard?
No, Billy. It wasn't the leopard. It was a creature I've never seen before or since.
That's creepy.
But from that day, my only wish is for all the animals of the savannah to live in peace and harmony.
You'll have to go on without me. I'm much too weak.
No, I will stay with Sushi and the tortoises and look after them. As for the lion and the weasel, they will find the water. And Toby and Smiley will accompany them.
At the Eden Paradise Hotel, we now find the participants of the 168th Conference on Climate Change in attendance. And here is someone who is clearly not the least impressed with any of it.
Hello, I'm Maya. For sure we all know what happens at these things. It's like you grown-ups love to hear each other talk and talk, and nothing ever happens.
I'm sure you're all awaiting the results of the conference as we are.
Ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you all here to the Eden Paradise as guests of the Climate Conference. The all-important job of the buffet opening falls to our very own house mascot. It's true. May I present Toto?
The water's trapped like a rat.
Who would do such a thing? Stolen your idea.
How did they get the hyena poo-poo so round?
I love it.
Cool.
Australians!
They're a strange breed of monkey. They're cute, though. A little funny looking, but cute. See you later, Billy.
Now, huh? Where's the beast, huh?
Oh, no!
You must know, I saved your life on my lunch break.
Now, gentlemen, if you please, I can guarantee you personally that this whole unfortunate fiasco is over.
Oh, his ears have gone red.
Here it comes! Smiley, I can't think of a better argument for good, clean outdoor living.
The wellness suite is solely for paying hotel guests.
Wild. Hey, Smiley, you try it on.
Hey, two words, gentlemen. Mini bar. Capiche? Voila! Hands off! This is the honeymoon suite! Okay, I'll watch for Hunter. You do not want to mess around with him. So you'd better behave yourselves if you know what's good for you.
Cool!
Hold on. Better we don't take a single shot. We hate bad press. Instead, I know, catch and send it to our casino in Vegas.
At least we can make a profit out of this whole mess.
I don't trust that monkey.
Didn't I tell you not to touch anything? Where is the armchair? You uncultured pig! We sit on chairs, we don't eat them! And where's the little guy?
Billy's in the water cave.
Splish splash, I was taking a bath. All about a Saturday night. Rubber duck just relaxing in the tub, thinking everything was alright.
That's quite enough rubber dubbing for today. I happen to have a job here, and I have no desire to get into trouble on account of you.
I worked hard to get my position. Oh, what is it you want from me?
Oh, we want water.
Right here you have water. So now if you would get out.
One thing, why on earth did you help us by hiding us in here?
Because with Hunter, you would have been killed.
So I see. You are one of us, after all.
No. I was born in a Brooklyn zoo. Not that you have any idea what that means. I'm very, very sorry, but you're dead wrong, and I am certainly not who you think I am. I am not one of your kind, for sure.
We need water. I mean, lots of water. For all of us.
Good. Then we go over to the dam, open the floodgates, and run the water to your valley. And then you folks get lost.
And so, what we have created is what we like to call an oasis of peace. In total harmony with nature, which is, of course, the key. And that's called ecological tourism. The result? Guaranteed sustainability with enough electricity generated to power several cities. You can imagine the benefits for the local economy.
Maybe you should be imagining what that means for the poor animals that live downstream. They're dying of thirst without water.
Maya, go to your room at once. You know nothing of this.
It's always about money, right? That's all you ever think about.
These kids. Go figure. And now, if you would follow me into the complex interior.
I'll go in there, open the spout, then I'll come back out. Meanwhile, you make sure you do not move from this spot.
Yeah! As you can imagine, the most modern and stringent security measures are utilized in this most sensitive of areas. Everything is state-of-the-art and hermetically sealed. Unauthorized access is totally out of the question.
Not fair. No, no, no!
Brave veterans, can you stand the pace?
We're fine, thank you. Though we're not quite as young as we used to be.
Well, I see. A beauty in the prime of her life.
Well, I'm 715 years old. Winston is 12 years older.
She has aged splendidly, my dear little lotus blossom.
You with a sweet talk.
L'amour. The heroism of the tortoises has saved us all. But without water, all that awaits us is certain death. And we are doomed if we go back to free Socrates and release the water. We are much too weak.
Then we have to get help. We'll call all the animals of the savannah.
Excellent, weasel.
Daddy? What are you doing with the lion?
Maya, Daddy has no time for this right now.
Set the lion free right now!
But it's not possible. There's nothing I can do. The lion is dangerous, and we can't just let it loose to run around all over the place. And besides, I've already sold the lion to a casino in Las Vegas.
You have successfully penetrated the security zone. While your friends have disappeared in the drink, you, looks like you're the lucky one. Smith sold you to a casino in Las Vegas.
Las what?
You hit the jackpot, top of the mountain. I've always dreamed of doing an appearance in Las Vegas just once.
I'm not hungry. Drink. It'll taste a lot better. Mom, did you have something to drink?
Of course I did.
You're a really bad liar, you know. Junior.
This is my waterhole, crocodile bait.
No.
You go find your own puddle, see? Or you can bite my horn!
Instead, I'll use your horn as a toenail clipper, okay?
You're asking for it!
£300 and not an ounce of brain, fatheads. Sweetheart.
Haven't you idiots got anything better to do?
Nope.
No.
Have you ever thought why you two are fighting in the first place?
Naturally. Because... Why do you think, Piggy?
Hey, I don't know.
Just as I thought. So from now on, go and play your juvenile game somewhere else. Got it?
Let's go talk to Angie. Angie's actually the president of Okavango.
A female president, Why not? I will attempt a bit of diplomacy, sir, the way I know how.
My skin is utterly and completely dried out. My nails are all cracked. My complexion, ruined. My lashes are like barbed wire. The end is near.
Giselle, we've got other things to worry about.
Oh, well, that's charming. I'm falling apart and you say we've got other things to worry about.
Oh, huh? Do not despair, madame.
Oh, no. I hear voices. Oh, I know this is the end. And I look like such a mess.
Hello, the name is Charles.
Charles? My, what a lovely name.
By the way, the oppressive heat can do nothing to hide your noble and sublime beauty.
Oh,
If I may be so bold, you seem to have been blessed with a delightful nose. So soft, and the most silky trunk.
Pooh, go marry her then.
We must call a conference, tout suite.
A conference?
A gathering of all the animals. There, we must figure out how this hero of yours was able to discover the water.
I have a hero? Who is it?
Yoo-hoo!
Billy? Then someone's got to blow the great horn.
There's a great gathering of the animals in 2 hours called a conference. You don't want to be late.
I'm on my way. Let's see. 2 hours. I know I can do it. Thank heaven for shortcuts.
Well, look who's here. It's the Lightwind.
Yeah, Miggy. What's so funny, Geradoff, eh?
We are all gathered together to discuss our precarious situation. And as you all may know, this is our first great historical animal gathering. For the duration of the proceedings, none of you will inflict harm upon another.
Fine by me.
If I may, the meerkats only really count as snacks, correct?
No one is allowed to touch anyone.
Eh?
Billy, your report?
Yeah, so here's the scoop. I found the water. Cool.
Who cares what that worm has to say? He's nothing but a squash fly on my hoof, see?
Problem is, the water's trapped way up in Leopard Canyon by these massive stones.
It was the leopard.
No, it was because of a bunch of strange, horribly ugly creatures, naked, without any fur.
Ugh, that's gross.
We're talking bloodthirsty, awful beasts. They call themselves humans.
What a pile of garbage. And since when did we ever listen to the drivel from a meerkat?
Chino is a dumb buffalo, but for once, he's got a point.
Mon ami, this, well, meerkat has shown more courage than all of you combined.
Those are some big words coming from you.
You little half-pint.
Do you have any idea what this little half-pint has been through? Do you know just how many of my comrades I have lost? The things I have seen from a dark dungeon, where my kind and I were locked up only to languish in the smallest of cells while wondering if we were to end up on a skewer, or perhaps a burgundy sauce. Mankind treats us like animals!
Well, that certainly was clear as mud.
And that's why we have to do something! We have to free up the water now!
Correct me if I'm wrong, but doesn't that mean we have to go through the Valley of Death? The water has always come, and it will come this time. We just have to wait.
The water is not simply water.
It is the blood of our forefathers.
Come on, what's with these two old-timers?
These two tortoises know mankind better than any other alive. And of course, much, much longer.
Good
evening.
My name is Winston, and...
I am called Winifred. We were born more than 700 years ago.
On an island located deep within the Pacific Ocean.
In all that time, we have come across many human beings.
They have stolen and have murdered.
And destroyed everything many, many times. And we let it happen. And because of this, we have lost everything. Our beloved home is sadly no more. Where once were blooming flowers of all colors, is now dry and arid. Where once the very air vibrated with the twittering of thousands of kinds of birds, is now only silence. Where once seals and the beasts of the ocean bobbed in the waves, all life is now at an end. Galapagos, our wondrous home, is now little more than a wretched, black, dark, and oily mass. The entire world is nothing more than a black, dark, and oily mass. Except for this place here. But if you do nothing to stop it, this place too will become no more than a blackened stain. For man is a thief who comes in the night and takes what he wants from the land. He is like a snake who eats his own tail to survive. But the earth does not belong to man. He is only a tiny part of it. Man did not weave the fabric of life. He's but a thread within it. For we all share the same breath. The rising mists of the lush green forests, the refreshment of the rocky mountain breezes, the perfumed scent of the wind after a cooling shower of rain, the plants, man, and we, the animals. What man doesn't realize is what he does to the land. He ultimately does to himself. And when the land is finally destroyed, and the animals are either driven out or killed, man will rule over the earth alone. Then lost and forlorn, he too will be wiped from the face of the earth. But that is a cold comfort to us now, for every one of you will perish if you don't defend yourselves against humanity.
You spoke wisely, and with great care.
Well, that's because they were your thoughts that I spoke.
What you spoke was greater than every thought.
And still all meaningless compared to my many years with you. Our years together. It's been wonderful. Good. So good.
Winnie? Winnie?
Winston and Winifred have gone to sleep for the last time.
but they live on in all of our dreams and in our hearts.
The tortoises have passed away.
Madame, we are waiting on your command.
But shouldn't we consult the Oracle first?
I don't think so, dear. Been there, done that. So, to battle!
And down with the beast!
And down with the beast!
Allons, et vive la liberté!
Could have done is consult the Oracle.
I get no respect. What happened to tradition? It's a disgrace.
Did you hear what I heard?
We've all been asking for advice from that guy, a hairdresser who talks from both sides of his mouth at the same time.
Sure, madame. It is a true honor to be allowed to march with you.
Yes, we're proud, but are we strong enough? Remember, the buffalo and the rhino didn't come along.
The heroic courage of our brave soldiers will make up for them.
Socrates, hang in there. We're coming.
How about those who don't have a banana milkshake? Or a drop of water?
Hey, I can read you like a book. You want to make me feel all guilty so that I'll help you escape. But you're wasting your time. I can't do anything. The big guy with the rifle's got the key to the cage.
Here I am, confined to a cage. But yet somehow I remain free. You're outside. But you are not really free at all, are you?
So, duty calls.
Just go. Playing monkey must be fun.
You put your right foot in, you put your right foot out. You put your right foot in and you shake it all about. You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about. You put your left foot in, you put your left foot out, and you shake it all about. You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about.
Clear, you're a meat eater. One can tell by that unpleasant breath. And have a little respect. Just look at yourself. Stand up straight. Chest out. And why are you so late? What kind of discipline is that for a soldier? Untake your incredibly filthy paws off my uniform. To your unit. This year, please.
Everything all right? My brave hero.
But of course, I simply had to reprimand a cowardly deserter.
Showtime!
Worthy of foes, yes, without question. Madame, if you would allow me, then I strongly suggest we send a message.
Send a message? And if we're not understood?
This message will be unequivocal.
Participant is leaving in an almost giddy, light, and ecstatic mood.
Yeah.
We cannot wait anymore! Let's go!
It's time for heads to roll!
Giselle, I've never heard you speak that way before.
Thank you.
And attack!
Very hard. This could be tricky. What is that roar?
It's the buffalo! And the rhinos, too!
You're drumming, Billy. You've got the groove.
I've got the groove.
Time has come. Party time!
Hotel is finished. I'm ruined. Are you satisfied?
Yeah. Look at how happy they are.
Your passion thrills me more than I can say.
Ma chérie, this is the first step on the journey of a lifetime.
From the 169th Climate Change Conference here at the United Nations in New York, I see that we may entertain some unexpected visitors. And it appears that the animals are finally going to make us accountable for our actions.
Howdy ho, jumpy body!
out. Where's the conference?
What? The conference of animals? Why, it's in America.
America? I just happen to have a shortcut.
Oh, what a shame. I could have given him a shame.
Children born, but we can let you get away with murder first degree.